So at its core, net neutrality rules answer a very simple question. Who gets to decide what we do online? Who gets to decide which content we get to see? Is it us, the internet users? Or is it the internet service providers, the companies that connect us to the internet? And the network neutrality answer is, it's us, the users, not the ISPs. If you take a step back, you might say, sort of the choice we are facing about the internet right now is what kind of technology we want the internet to be. Do we want it to be more like electricity, where you have an electric plug, but then whatever you put in the plug will work and it's up to you to decide what to do with the electricity? Or do you want a technology that's more like cable networks, where you get content nicely packaged in bundles that the cable operator has selected for you? And so throughout the talk, you get a better idea of why this is actually a pretty good analogy. So what exactly did the FCC do and why? So the Open Internet Order, which is the document that adopts the network neutrality rules, has two big parts. One is a set of bright line rules. Bright line rules are rules that tell the internet service providers exactly what they can and cannot do. As we found out during the proceeding, that's actually really important, not just for the ISPs, but also for other market. You want certainty. You want to be able to look at the rules and know what they want from you. They give you low cost of regulation. So there are three bright line rules, and I'll talk more about them later. They talk about the three key practices that we are worried about: blocking, discrimination, and what we call fast lanes in the US. The FCC called it no pay prioritization. And then there is a general conduct rule. And that rule is not a bright line rule, because the FCC said, well, our bright line rules don't capture all the behavior that we already know about, and they definitely don't capture behavior that might happen in the future. And so we want to give users and every member of the internet community a way to complain to the FCC and say, we think that this practice hurts innovation, hurts competition, hurts users, hurts free speech, and we look at that case by case. And then finally, and that was a very big step in the US as well, they for the first time included the intersection between the access network, that is the network you connect to when you access the internet, and the other networks that are part of the internet. They included that and said, we will also look at what happens there, and if you think there are problems at the point of interconnection, you can come to us and complain.